I can honestly say to myself and anybody else that I love to write. And I write primarily for myself because that's the person I'm trying to fulfill my dreams. However, as I've become more fluent with my books, I find that I no longer stand alone. There's a lot of other people that enjoy my thoughts. I try to put in 3 to 4 hours a day, 7 days a week.
Sometimes on Sunday, if I, you know, went to family functions, I may not have, but I tried to stay with it. It was flowing so well that I was enjoying writing it. So I never had a block where I would have to take time off. It just kept revolving and revolving. Well, with my book, Paisano Brothers, I wrote 5 hours a night for 2 years.
Well, for me, my job kind of occupies my time, so this ends up being a hobby, so it's a weekend experience. I'll get up before my family, like 6 o'clock in the morning, and I'll write till about 12. So that's like what I do on the weekends, and then do my errands later.
I tried to write mainly on nights and weekends because, you know, obviously I work. I would typically put in probably 5 or 6 hours on a Saturday, maybe another 5 or 6 hours on a Sunday. And the first book took me about 12, 14 months to write that way. I moved around the house at first, and I just kind of started to get comfortable in our TV room on our couch, and I kind of developed this weird process about just putting the TV guide on the channel because it wasn't an actual TV show, it wasn't anything going to be distractive. I'd sit in the TV room, I'd put the TV guide, and the channels would just scroll, and I would get to work, and I would try to do about, like I said, about 10 to 12 hours per weekend. And it actually really all started from back in 2004, I started to put my ideas into a writing journal, okay? And it wasn't until 4 years later that I went to this writing journal where I'd been listing ideas and going through them and, you know, throwing some of them out and, defining some other ideas. And when I finally said 4 years later that I'd never set out to fill up a writing journal, it looks like that was what I was doing. I had to remind myself that I set out to write a book. So I actually had, in 2008, I sat down and took the ideas out of the writing journal and actually started to write the book. And that was maybe one of the hardest things to do, was to just, instead of just listing ideas that I was trying to refine, to actually look at a blank sheet of paper where there's nothing there and just say, one day that's going to be a book. And I got started in 2008.
Well, I was a school teacher, and I just thought after the first date that this would be a great book, a great movie. And I just started jotting things down and a couple of hours here and there on flashcards that I used in my classroom. And after several years, I put it together, and I ended up getting, you know, the manuscript together. And now I'm working on a book called Moms from Hell. It's basically a spin-off from the Internet Dates from Hell on how the same person, myself, leaves New York, moves to Colorado, and encounters unique moms. And it's funny, it's kind of tongue-in-cheek, nothing serious. I think if you limit yourself or you put too many restrictions on, you lose creativity. So I just pick up the pen, and when I have ideas, or for any ideas, or either whether it's a book for anything creative, I'll just write it as it comes. I keep a notebook next to me. So if I dream something, I usually put it in the notebook. So I find whenever the thought comes to mind, if you don't have a notebook, you can use your iPad or, you know, jot things down like that.
I would like to be very prolific with my writing, but I'm actually trying to write every day. I'm trying to get on a schedule. I can't say that I've actually done it, but I always feel best about myself when I do write every day. So even if I just get in a half an hour or an hour, usually once I get started, though, it's a good chunk, usually 4 or 5 hours.
I was actually staying at my mother-in-law's, and I was staying in a basement apartment, and I didn't really talk to her much, so I started writing. And I would take 2 hours, I decided to write my memoirs, and I would take 2 to 3 hours a night. I focused on that. So I developed this pattern of doing this. No matter what, I would take those 2 to 3 hours to write. Only when I get an inspiration, and sometimes when I'm sleeping or when I'm trying to sleep, I will get an idea, and I have a pad next to my bed with a pen. I got used to that, And even without looking at the pad, I just touch it. I know where the pad is. I'll just scribble some words, a couple of sentences of the idea.
I used to do a lot of driving. And to me, that's wasted time, getting from point A to point B. And so as soon as I got in and started the car, the movie would turn on. It isn't a thought process, so I do tend to keep my eyes on the road as well. But the story will develop, so I may start with the idea, have an overall idea of where I'm going to begin, and then each time I get out into the car and drive, I will advance the story. And I repeat it over and over and over in my head until I get home or until I get to a destination, and then I immediately type it. I have tried voice recording it while I'm thinking it, but drive, voice, record, think doesn't work.
My writing process is, well, we work a full-time job. I'm a college professor. And but even after 10 hours of lecture in a day, to come home and write something becomes exhausting. You know, I mean, writing in the morning is my best way, but I have to promise myself that only if it's one sentence, I will write something every day, because that's one sentence I am closer to the end. And when I can have the blocks of time, when I can put out a lot, I'll put out a lot. And I've never really had writer's block, but by the same token, there are days when I can't even keep up with the thoughts, that they're just flowing so easily. Other days when I will struggle 2 hours to get a sentence right. But you never know how it's going to come up. Also about the writing process is interesting. People ask me, how have you come up with all the nuances of plot in here? How did you think of those? My answer is I didn't. And here's what I mean. I had a basic storyline, and I started writing. And as I wrote, I would discover things. I go, oh yeah, that would work. Even if I had to go back a couple chapters earlier and change something to make it work, it was continual discovery process. So with the finished product, I came up with stuff here that I have no idea where it's from. And if I sat there trying to outline it, I never could have come up with. But the creative process just breaks it loose and things start flowing like that. And so that's kind of the process.
My writing process. When I did my first book, I was still working full-time as a registered nurse. So I would see my husband off to work in the morning, and I would just sit down at the computer and just start writing for hours. I get so caught up in it, I had to start putting the timer on the stove so it would remind me, oh, it's time to get ready for work. So because I was still working full-time, it really took a much longer to do that. But I really have to discipline myself to write. I've given up an awful lot of TV watching, which I really don't miss. And, you know, I just have to be at it pretty much every day. It's really not a part-time job. If you're using it as your job, then I'm pretty much writing every day. And just the discipline of getting yourself to write. I don't set writing goals like, oh, I'm going to write 2,000 words today. I don't set goals like that. Some writers do, and that works for them. But I do write something pretty much every day.
Initially, I started out with a pen and paper. And from that, after I got so many thoughts down, I go to the computer. And that's the best way for me. I had to literally put it up in front of me and type it. To just sit up and just type my thoughts out on the computer, I just couldn't do it that way. So it's pen and paper, I'm old fashioned. When I started writing, it would be, my thing was I'd be asleep and it would all come to me in the middle of the night. And I'd get up at 1 o'clock in the morning, 2 o'clock in the morning, right till 5 o'clock in the morning, sleep an hour, get up for work. And now it's just, so I have so much going on that it's just when a thought comes to me, I just put it down. So that's pretty much how it goes. It's just, it's sporadic. There's no set consistent time that I actually write. It's just when it happens, because writer's block comes into play a lot of the times for most people, so it's when it comes to me.
Usually my writing process starts with an idea. Okay, I get an idea for a story. And I decide who I want to act out that story. And I create a character, develop, you know, her appearance, her life, her past, her present, her future, what it is she wants, you know, what it is she is wrestling with. We are all wrestling with something or other. So I give my character some trials, some tribulations, some aspirations, some dreams and whatnot. then plot, setting, and supporting characters. I decide who her leading man is going to be, also who her antagonist is going to be. And then the story just sort of comes together. With my first novel, I really did outline closely. I knew what scene I wanted to have. And with the second, I just went with the flow. I let it, you know, whatever came to mind that should happen next. You know, this happened, then that happened. The third novel was sort of like a combination of both, and I don't know what I'm going to do next. I try to write every day, and it varies. If there's something in particular I want to work on, then I work on that issue that day, maybe that chapter, maybe it's just revision. You know, each day has a different purpose. Sometimes I listen to music if I find myself getting a little, having what they call writer's block or something, don't know where to go from here, don't know what kind of mood my character needs to be in at this point. Then listening to music, I may take time out. To me, that is still writing, even though I'm relaxing listening to music. I am writing because I'm writing in my head. I'm wondering how this music speaks to my character, how they, it relates to my character's maybe moods or emotions or whatever. And if there's a story within that song, you know, maybe that song relates to their story in some kind of way. So that's writing. I also write in my head a lot without listening to music, just while doing anything. Just about anything around you can be material. You know, you can see a car going down the street. If it's a certain model car, if it's doing, you know, say it's speeding or something, that can be material. A novel, so you know, I write when I'm even not actually in front of my computer writing.
So my books take place in the antebellum South of the USA. So I had to do a lot of research. I'm a Canadian, so I don't have all that pre-Civil War history and the slave history, the underground. So I had to do a lot of research. I usually try and have a general map of where I'm going with my story. I use post-it notes, nice, bright, colorful post-it notes, and I put them in order, chapter by chapter, and that way if I go astray or if I come up with a new idea, I can move my post-it notes around. Okay, so that helps keep me organized, and as I get new thoughts, or if I change the concept, I just throw away the post-it note as opposed to having to start something totally different.
At the time I started writing the book, which was January of 2007, I was working at a contract email job and just kind of writing on my lunch hour. The book, to a great extent, I mean, as much as I'd always wanted to write a book and had been an English major at UCLA, I'd always wanted to write a book, but this book, after I sort of brainstormed with ideas, the book kind of, a lot of things would just come to me. But finding the time, the privacy, because writing is a very solitary process, and so finding the time to be able to be alone and to work on it was really quite a process. I would go to cafes, I would write, an idea would strike me and I would pull over in the car. But basically I wrote longhand when I would get an idea and then input it that night into my computer. And went through the whole process of trying to find a literary agent, which is, you know, really, really tough. But I had known somebody who had gone through Author House, and you know, she was really pleased with it, so then I decided to go to Author House.